So.
Okay, my name's Vori. Vori Vori actually is, even though it's spelled Mari Vori, Scottish guy name. So there's a degree of repetition to start with. Basically, I'm an artist, and I make sculptural installations, and I'm working my way through finding out how I locate myself in this kind of context of conference. I proposed initially making a piece of work, which I spent yesterday installing in the basement of the building, and I considered that to be my sort of major contribution to the conference. But just to contextualise that, I'm going to flash through a lot of images, and I'm going to talk primarily about a material process of making. And through that, there is an inference and a reference to, particularly to the writing of Deleuze and Guattari, which is something I've arrived at, to aid in understanding the processes that I've been exploring. I'm particularly interested at the moment in the rhizome for establishing a set of conditions that support necessity for unknowingness and uncertainty as a methodology in the construction of our installations. So I will just talk, I will describe the work, and then after that leave you to have space to go down and work in the basement. This is a piece that was located in an art school in Birmingham at the end of a period of residency. I have a strong relationship to architecture, so I'm interested in the way that people move through spaces and use spaces, and how you can situate physical objects to activate those spaces or to have some sort of dialogue with space. So encounters with the work can come from very different dimensions. So as you get nearer the work, it takes on a different perspective, a different form, until you encounter it basically directly. This piece consists of hundreds, if not thousands, of pieces of MDF wood cut into strips and then snapped through a physical process, dipped into water, dipped into Dylon fabric dye, and then shoved into, wedged into what is actually a security grill from a transit van. So I work with materials that exist in the world around me. I like to play with the materials, play through process of thinking through making, and arriving at conditions where in some way the work can form itself as well as my intervention with those materials. So this piece starts off wet, and over the duration of the exhibition the dye and the water seep into the MDF wood. The MDF, which is snapped, is vulnerable at the end, so the wood begins to expand. So going from a nice geometric constructed piece of work, it becomes something that begins to collapse and begins to take on its own slight form. Throughout the process of the exhibition, the dye crystallises as well, because it's wood salts, so you get this other surface existing across the top of the work. The other thing that I'm interested in at the moment as well is the proposition, because work is often made in situ and only exists in situ, they're not discrete works, is how those works translate into different spaces and what happens when you take a piece of work with a title and a certain kind of set of ideas and strands behind it, and to make it exist in different contexts and how that dialogues with the context around it as well. So this is a refined version of the first work that was then placed in a kind of slightly cleaner, more refined gallery space. This is another piece that was constructed in the context of the art school, again playing with the perspective from a balcony view to encounter the object on the same level, and you get closer into the object. This piece is constructed from thousands of twigs that were gathered, so it's a process of gathering, and this process of collecting and walking is part of the process of thinking the work as much as it is exploring the work in the space. The dimensions of the work were all constructed in relation to the space and how there had to be fire spaces, and there was a foyer building, so there was a certain movement of people around the space. And there are a certain set of parameters and conditions that then begin to dictate how that work is going to be constructed. So this is made out of twigs piled up together and stuck together with glue gun glue, which is a craft material. And that is the thing that actually ties the whole work together. In the centre of this nest-like construction is a gazing bowl. So stainless steel gazing bowl, which is a garden ornament, which plays with the reflection, so you begin to lose a sense of what's the object, what's not, what begins to be bits of architecture around as you look into it. and the spaces become less defined. The glue itself takes on its own form, it drips and it dribbles and it lands. To begin with, when you start working with materials, so that you go through a process of trying to control them. It was mentioned earlier about using paint on a brush and allowing the paint to do something itself, and how you get a kind of power from allowing things to use their own materiality in the generation of a piece of work. So that's the relationship again to the architecture, using that very much as a stimulus for the nature of the diagrammatical elements of the work, of picking up on the pixelated floor, the Victorian materials and the richness of that. And there we are, there's an image of just looking in where it begins to tell what's real, what's reflection, what's happening around. This is part of an installation of the same work, but in a very different context, in a very different form. This work actually is called Hub. The first work is called Shift. So a lot of the titles and nature of the work relates to the virtual realm and virtual dimensions, as well as our physical environments. So this time the piece was constructed on top of a desk inside a gallery, so it becomes about the work inhabiting the space. And again, how people walk through and walk around the space, and allowing those strands of glue to have a bit more presence and do their own thing. This is a piece called Domain. It's constructed by stripping back thousands of metres of communication and data cable to get all those little coloured strands and elements back out again. And there's a strong relationship to painting in the way that this work is actually installed. It's quite gestural. Just for practicality's sake, when you start playing with the material, discovering what's inside the cable, how many colours you get, how thick the different cables are, you have to do something with them, you wind them up to keep them neat at that point in time. So the whole process of arriving at the form of the work comes out of this process, a long period of playing with work. One of the other things that I'm interested in as well is what are often given as spaces for presenting work, which try to blank out the architectural features of the rooms that exist. And it's something that I've encountered in making the piece of work here, and it's something that I'm embracing much more now. You can see there I've tried to obliterate the room to make a white space in which to make the work. There's still a grill in the floor, there are still features in that space that actually become part of the work when you present work in those spaces, or I choose to make them part of the work. So this kind of landscape that's been created, and in some sense a figure there wedged into the grate in the room. This domain shifted and was then reconstructed in Imperial College in London, which was quite interesting because it's a dialogue mainly with scientists then at that point, as opposed to artists or creatives. So again, a gallery space, what's designated a gallery space, but as a set of cupboards through the middle of it, and basically is a walk-through corridor. So I decided to engage with that in a way that could, so this kind of transitional in the corridor, with glass cupboards and the reflection down one side. Fire alarm in the corner, plugs, sockets, all of these things become part of the dialogue with the work, rather than ignoring them or trying to pretend that they don't exist. Just detail the wires. So in the cupboards, the run of glass fronted cupboards along the other side, I had to find some way to engage those as part of the work. So this is chopped up data cable into tiny little fragments. I've been interested in noise and how you kind of deal with entropy and kind of the giving of information. And also in those cupboards then as well, was set the last cupboard, was a glass bowl in which I chucked in a set of items which I knew would then generate their own being in some way, shape or form. So this is a glass bowl filled with a piece of copper shin which is just quickly modelled into a form. A small stainless steel bathing bowl, a load of salt and a load of white vinegar, and then it's just shut into the cupboard for a month for the duration of the exhibition. And throughout that time, this generated its own life, basically. Until in the end, sorry, this is fuzzy, this is taken through two layers of gloves. There was a whole little world beginning to emerge in that set of conditions. This is another piece that I installed. This is called Law Memory. So basically, my work was the piece at the side, which is a set of silk ties conjoined. One single tie, fat end gets two ties, two thin ends of tie into it. So it's a series of bifurcations. Fat end to the next tie gets two ties into it, so it's an exponential growth, basically, playing with the idea of diagrams and organisation of information, and how that becomes unreadable or unintelligible. In the middle of installing the work, this wall was getting painted black, and then suddenly I kind of walked away and came back, and this big graphic symbol had appeared. So it's kind of interesting. It becomes part of the work. It's not completely irrelevant, but it is very much beyond my control. So here you can see a close-up of the silk ties, which are stuffed with polystyrene balls. They're joined together using the clips that are used to connect hose pipes onto sinks and things. So very functional. And then to stop the stuffing coming out the ends of the balls, it could perpetuate itself, it could keep growing. But temporarily, they're contained by sock balls. So a lot of people store their socks by holding them one into the other. That's what kind of stuffs the end of the ties to stop it escaping. So there's another layer of meaning going on in that as well. There you can see one of the clips that actually just ties the whole piece together. And this is the same piece then taken into another space and actually exploring a very different kind of architecture and a very different relationship to the nature of its form. This is an iteration of the work that I've made downstairs. This is a body of work that's kind of generated itself physically over the past year, called Perpetual Doubt, Constant Becoming, exploring this state of not knowing where your work is going to go, where it's next going to pop up, how it's going to take its form, and that kind of constant uncertainty that I'm faced with in producing artworks. This is not chronological, none of this work is chronological at all either. Work doesn't develop in that way most of the time for me. So this is generated from thousands of elastic bands, hundreds of thousands of elastic bands, loom bands. They've been a bit of a craze recently, that craze is now defunct. So it's a thinking process, thinking time. I've spent hundreds of thousands of hours knitting these things together as children do to make bracelets, but just taking it to a level beyond that. This is installed in the cellar of a gallery space, and there is actually a hole through. It's an old coal cellar, I think, where they used to drop the coal through. So there is a pool of light at the bottom, and I've kind of capitalised on that by having a heap of the stuff that is the making of the rest of the installation. There's a detail of it and the dampness of the space, so playing with the colourfulness and pleasure of those materials in a dirty, dark space. This is another version of the installation, which was installed in a barn on a farm estate in Gloucestershire. So again, it's been opportunistic about the offerings of the architecture available. I believe these cages were used for the rearing of young partridges and pheasants. This architecture just still existed within the barn, so I worked with that and played with the strands across the space. Some little moments and some bigger gestures. And this is an image which hope you'll just pop down and have a look at the work yourself. Images taken quickly yesterday of the work installed downstairs. It's the first time I've done it where I walk into a space. I've never seen it before. I've been furnished with a few images. I have a number of hours to actually get in there and make a piece of work. So it's about that responsiveness, and it's about stopping that fear of trying to control how a piece of work exists and embracing the features and the conditions that are actually given to you. In the making of all of these works, I establish quite strong sets of parameters so that they come quite tight in the end. And in the making of this piece, instead of having ends of strands, ends of hundreds of strands, all the pieces are actually linked together, so there are no ends in this piece. Also, none of the strands actually touch each other in the process of their hanging as well, so there are certain set of conditions that become part of the game of actually placing this material in space, where the fridge doesn't become a problem and the cable from the fridge actually begins more of a dialogue with what's happening in the space around it. It's a bit like the aftermath of the Christmas party. And where the strands weave their way around the furniture as well, it's always that thing, do you empty out space, do you clean it out, where does the work locate itself in relation to the context, the physical context? And then one last gesture to trying to locate myself within the bigger realms of this conference, of not knowing whether I'm making a presentation or I'm an encounter or I'm an artist, what am I, where are you within that whole thing? And I've been really intrigued since it came out, the latest version of the conference diagrams, of understanding what we should be looking at, where we should be going, trying to work our way around, and how that relates to the nature of my work. So here I'm located within that. It's another attempt and a little gesture to finding myself within the bigger realms. And this, just to end, is a new exploration with this work, which is a proposition I'm kind of toying with for making a piece of work in a swimming pool and the environment as well. On playing with this stuff in water, I realised there are different densities of rubber, so parts of it flow, part of it sinks. It just kind of seemed interesting to translate it into a different medium altogether. Whether that's realised, whether I need to realise that in the end, I'm not sure. That's a possibility of being on the project. Anyway, I hope you'll look at the work downstairs and yeah.
Thank you.